You used to be able to get things pretty cheap when you go to the clearance aisles at various stores and so on. But there's a new trend happening that's taking away good deals from ordinary people. Hey there, NJ, Route22.com. Today we're talking about something, I like to call them eBay flippers, but I guess you can call this a public service announcement. And my whole point, if you don't feel like watching the rest of this video, is that if you see something good on a clearance aisle at any major store, and it's something you can use and you'd be happy to save money, don't wait till the price goes down. Like, buy it, okay? If the price goes down, you can probably get a price adjustment later, but the chance is that if you see something you like and you don't buy it, it's gonna be gone very quickly. Why? Because there's somebody I call them eBay flippers or fulfillment by Amazon, FBA people that are all out there trying to make a few extra bucks from low priced things, deals on items, consumer goods mostly. I call them bottom skimmers because they're literally, like, for someone like me, I'm not an eBayer. I don't flip things. I saw something and I didn't buy it, and it was like half the price that it normally was. And I'm like, I changed my mind. I went back the next day to buy it, and it was gone. Like, the whole aisle was like half empty compared to the day before at Walmart, because somebody thought they can get something cheap and instantly flip it and double their money or close to double their money. And these were actually sockets, these Stanley sockets. They were really good, actually. They were a metric, which is I need for my tool collection. I have plenty of SAE sizes, but I don't have metric. And a lot of the products I have these days use metric. And I had the whole range. I should have bought them. They were $30, even though the price said $45. And they were normally like $60. I should have picked them up. But so what I did was I went on eBay to see, and there was hundreds of these Stanley sockets, all selling for about the same price, because they're eBay flippers all over the entire country who probably saw the same deal I did. They go there daily, or they know when Walmart puts out new items, or what day of the week that I think it's every week or two, the price goes down another 10 to 20 to 30%. And they put a new yellow sticker on the things, and they know, they get there at 8 a.m. and they buy everything that went down in price. They also have these apps, BrickSeek, and there's all these different apps that you can, or websites you can use to track products. And it's become very automated. But eBay flippers are very interesting. Oh, by the way, I did get this box of Gillette razors. And it was four blades, a handle, and a tub of shaving cream. And it was only $5. It probably saved me, 75%. Buying those three things separately probably would have cost $20. And I went online to see if anybody was selling these things, and none had sold in the last year. So a lot of these people are running into trouble. I'll explain right now. This new trend now, everybody thinks, because you'll see some like fast-talking guy on TikTok or Instagram or Pinterest talking about how, you can make easy money, buy it cheap and sell it higher. Yes, that concept used to work very well, because you were the only one buying cheap and selling on eBay or Amazon, a little bit less than you can get it normally. Now everybody thinks they can sell things for the same price as that you can get them at the store. I would never buy from eBay unless I know I'm getting it for 50% or more off. I buy my cell phones for 10 cents on the dollar. It was $1,000 new, I get it for $100. I will never buy anything on eBay that's not profoundly cheaper. And anybody buying anything on eBay that they can get or used to be able to get at Walmart for the same price is smoking crack. So what I think is what's happening here is that all these people think, the concept is very good on paper. You can indeed buy and sell on eBay. But this trend has been going on for a long time, and there's professionals out there that do this for a living, making a hefty six-figure salary, but they know what they're doing. And anybody getting into the game in 2020 and beyond is in for a rude awakening, because unless you put in 7 days a week and you're working 18 to 20 hours a day on posting your stuff, and you probably need a staff and a warehouse to keep your things organized. That's why a lot of people are liking FBA, funded fulfillment by Amazon, because they don't have to do any of the shipping. They pay a higher fee. I think it's upwards of 30% or more, but they don't have to handle the logistics, which is nice, but their stuff may never sell and may sit in Amazon warehouse collecting dust for a year. But anyway, anybody getting into it now is it's like I liken to a pyramid scheme. The people who get into a pyramid scheme early, usually the ones that make out. And the longer you wait and the bigger the pyramid gets, the less chance you have of being successful. And people today now are, I mean, I can understand doing it. If you can find 10 things a month and flip them on eBay for a modest profit, like some people can make an extra grand a month, which is nice because it could be recreational pocket money to help them or maybe even help them with their bills. But at this point, if you're planning on replacing your life with becoming an eBay flipper, unless you have a niche, going to Walmart and trying to flip those things, you have a huge competition field out there now. There's people out there, there's, I don't know how many thousands of Walmarts there are, but there's people that go to every single solitary one, run home and put that stuff on eBay, all trying to sell it. I mean, I guess one good tip is if you can do this successfully daily and buy things and have the money to buy things, flip them at a lower price than everybody else. If everybody's selling these $30 sockets for $58.96, which is what Walmart was selling them for, sell them for $45. Make $5 profit, I guess, after shipping and eBay fees. See, at that point, to put an hour worth of work in for $5 is you're pushing your luck. Don't do it. Just buy the things that you might need. And so on. So I'm not happy with how these eBay flippers are kind of taking away my good deals. And at the same time, it's no fun even flipping things on eBay anymore unless you have high ticket items with a lot of profit and you are buying from China, by the way. The profitable drop ship stores. All these people are claiming profitable drop shipping stores. Again, the market is way too saturated. I don't know, if you do it right and you're perfect and on all levels, you might be able to make a decent living, but the field is too crowded and the other big guys like Amazon are getting bigger. And I think you gotta figure out a better way to make some money. Design something that nobody's done, designed anymore. Anyway, I've rambled on and on here, but just like I said, bottom line, if you see something you like and it's a good deal, pick it up. Don't buy with the intention to make a profit. If you like the video, please hit subscribe and hit the bell. I have 3 videos a week, and I do my best to talk about interesting subjects from an honest point of view. Have a good day.